It's a great day here today. Beautiful day. It's a beautiful day for us, but it's also a beautiful day for fish and aquatic wildlife here in the little river as we've taken out this dam, which blocked for decades fish moving upstream, being able to find their native spawning habitat.
This is very exciting. It's going to open up a good portion of this the river and the Densons Creek that you could probably take a canoe and go a few miles up and down. So that's exciting and will be a blessing for us in the future. I was raised in a little community called Okeeweemy, maybe 5 miles from here, but I was raised in there. And my boyhood days, I traveled up and down this these streams, Denson Creek and Little River, and barefooted and having a great time. Now we have trails up and down this the river and the creek, and sometimes you get out there and you feel like you are a thousand miles away from anybody, and it's really, really pretty.
So we're looking at a series of dam removal and fish passage projects along these streams that are going to open up this habitat for several at-risk species of fish and mussel. It's a great partnership. It involves the city of Troy, North Carolina, and other programs in the Department of Parks, and a whole host of partners all contributing bits and pieces of these major projects that are going to really improve the habitat.
And last year we took out Dynamo Dam here. We're renting a local equipment and using fisheries and refuge employees to take out this structure in just under a day. These projects have opened up 55 main stem miles and over 350 tributary miles to the benefit of endemic mussels and diadromous species such as American eel and American shad and blueback herring.
Another reason we do stream restoration, river restoration by removing barriers such as dams is to provide better fishing quality for anglers. Where above the dam it was just sediment laden, it was not good fish habitats. And once you remove the barrier, slowly over time the sediment will dissolve and the substrate will be back to provide great fish habitat.
It's also a great opportunity for people who are paddling the river, where we once had this obstruction that that prevented people from paddling down and actually endangered them in some of the dangerous currents below the dam. With this obstruction removed, people can now paddle through, and there's actually a new access point also being put in here. So we're really excited about what this means for the river and for people in this area to be able to use the river. And we want to thank all the partners involved with this, including the City of Troy, U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, and many others that have been involved.